Yes. And into the vast deserts of broken lands. As the days passed, my companion told me of himself, that he had once been a great warrior, and that a dark and secret burden now weighed heavily upon him. We traveled for an eternity across that barren wasteland. How long ago? I couldn't say, and always a dark cloud seemed to follow us just over the horizon. Finally, the journey ended. We climbed the last bridge. There below us lay our destination, the shining jewel, Lut Gholein, with a great sea beyond. We made camp that last night. Perhaps it was the warm desert wind or the sound of the ocean, but for the first time in many weeks, I slept. However, the dreams returned, but these were clearly not my own. I beheld a vision of a great man, the mage Talrasha. You were there too, Tyriel. I remember seeing you in my dream. His brethren had cornered a great demon, Baal, Lord of Destruction, who had been set loose upon the world. They attempted to imprison the demon within a sacred stone. Yet when their attempts failed, Talrasha selflessly volunteered to contain the demon within himself, completing the prison. He instructed his brethren to bind him within a tomb, buried under the sand, there to wrestle with the demon for all eternity.
Now you know what I seek, Marius. This is my brother. Sleep now. We set out with the dawn.
The next morning, we walked over the hill toward Lut Gholein. I had no idea then of the horrors that were in store for me there.
Good day. Greetings, honored traveler. I am Jerhyn, Lord of Lut Gholein, and I bid you welcome to my fair port city. I'm glad to know that once again, caravans are free to travel through the Western Pass. For some time now, we have been under siege by an evil power that I cannot identify. Strange. It all began when a dark wanderer came this way, looking for the tomb of Talrasha. No one knows exactly where Talrasha, Keeper of Baal, is entombed, but it is certain to be far out in the desert. Now my people whisper tales of the dead rising from their tombs, and horrible creatures lurking amongst the moonlit dunes. Even I have witnessed things which I cannot explain. I've ordered the port closed and all trade ships moored until I am sure that my city is safe. Atma, the tavern keeper, has an important mission for you. Go see her immediately. You'll find her on the other side of town. Now I must return to the palace. I apologize, but I can't invite you in. Things are rather a mess right now. For trade in magic and the like, see Drognan or Lysander. Drognan is the wisest man I know, without equal in magic and ancient lore. poor Lysander is nearly deaf, but he's a reliable potion chemist. Or travel back west, see Wariv, whom you already know. Our own Farah is a fine and honest armorer, and she can heal wounds as well. Elzix is the innkeeper, and may also have some items to trade. Graze, the mercenary captain I hired to secure the gates of Lut Gholein, keeps order in town as well. There are others here too. I'm sure you'll meet most of them. Just look around.
Halt! You may not pass. You look like a sturdy adventurer. You know, I used to be quite the scoundrel in my day. I led the fiercest group of bandits who ever terrorized these sands. Nowadays, I run this here inn and pretty much stay out of trouble. My days of adventuring are behind me.
I bet you wonder how this town manages to stay safe with all the trouble going on out in the desert. Well, I can tell you that it's got nothing to do with the local town guards. They're all in the palace for some reason. Jerhyn hired me and my mercenaries to help keep the peace around here. We're not cheap, but we're the best this wasteland has to offer.
I've heard that you are responsible for banishing Undariel back to the Burning Hells. I'm impressed, stranger. That couldn't have been easy. My name is Drognan, and I know what you're up against, my friend. You ought to look over my inventory of items for trade.
About the ancient religions. I was trained as a paladin of Zakharum in the Eastern Koras Temple many years ago.
How do I know I can trust you, hmm? You may be as shifty as that pack rat Elzix who runs the inn. But if you need a potion, though, I suppose I can make you one. For a price, of course.
Hello.
Now that Undariel is dead, I can return and outfit the rogues properly. Once I've made some trades here, I'll be free to head back to their monastery. Let me know if you want to travel along.
Greetings. I'm Mashif, captain of this ship here. I make port runs around the Twin Seas and occasionally out to Kingsport in Westmarch. I haven't sailed anywhere lately, though. Jerhyn has ordered me to stay docked here in case of emergency.
Good evening. I don't expect this of you. But if you want to help me, I would be grateful. In the sewers below our city, there lurks a horrid creature that hungers for human flesh. The creature has killed many, including my son and my husband. If you destroy it, I will reward you. Please, be careful, though. That beast has taken enough from us already. The sewer entrance is through the trapdoor, just up the street.
Keep pestering me. Grays seems to have this place locked down nice and tight. Not that I couldn't have done the same. I've proven my valor in combat plenty of times.
Let me buy you a drink.
Hey!
Don't touch my drink, or I'll bore a hole into your skull with my thumb.
Approach and let's trade. Farah and I have been talking about the creature recently. From my studies, I have deduced that it is Radament the Fallen, an ancient Horadric mummy that has for some reason left his tomb to prey on mortals. I'm doing some more research now. If you check back later, I may have some more insight as to his nature.
Good evening. I've personally found some of that devil's victims washed up out of the sewer. Often they are missing limbs or a head, and their bodies have always been skinned. At first, the creature raided the town at night. That's how Atma lost her family. Now we've got him barricaded in the sewers. You're safe up here on the surface, but every now and again, some fool wants to be a hero and heads down to the waste tunnels with a pig sticker.
Good evening. I hear that the creature kills his victims in order to hack off their limbs. I guess that makes me a less likely candidate, eh?
Good evening. I've heard tales of walking corpses out in the desert at night. Though I've never actually seen one.
Greetings. I hear that beast is after body parts. Does he eat them? Ooh, ghastly.
It is an honor to serve you.
I believe that the creature you refer to is one of the ancient Horadric mummies from the tombs that lie buried beneath the desert sands. It is unusual for one of his kind to be so far away from his resting place. I sense in this entity a restless and malevolent spirit.
The Horadrim used to mummify their highest mages and infuse them with spells that would allow them to protect their tombs, even after death. I have no idea why one of them would be acting so malevolently. Perhaps Drognan or Farah would know more about this.
Good evening. There are two entrances to the sewers, I believe. One of them is right near here, down by the water beneath the docks. I can see it from my ship, and you can bet I keep an eye on it every night.
This is for you.
I'll put that to good use. Put that to good use.
Thank you.
Vengeance. I can't carry anymore. I am overburdened. Hello. They say that the taste of vengeance is bittersweet, but I find it to my liking. In addition to my undying gratitude, I have spoken on your behalf with the rest of the townspeople. The merchants have agreed to show their gratitude by offering their wares and services at lower rates. Oh, Jerhyn wants to see you too. You'll find him in front of the palace.
Yes? Whoa, whoa. Radament the Fallen, is it? I've fallen off many a bar stool, and no one calls me Geglash the Fallen. They might go so far as to say, Geglash, you've fallen.
Good evening.
Ah, the lost Horadric scroll. What a fortunate turn of events. As the last living Horadrim, I alone have knowledge of its meaning. Now, to read the Horadric runes it bears. The Horadric mages, after binding Bale within Tal Rasha, magically sealed off his burial chamber from the mortal realm. Those same mages also crafted fearsome Horadric staves and imbued them with the special power to open the chamber's hidden door. After nearly losing one to the thievery of a rogue sorcerer, they divided all the Horadric staves into two parts, wooden shaft and metal headpiece, hiding them separately to safeguard them. The Horadrim foresaw our current plight and designed the hiding places to reveal themselves to worthy heroes like you. Collect both parts of a Horadric staff and unite them using a Horadric cube. Then you may enter Tal Rasha's burial chamber. If you haven't already, tell Atma that Radament is dead. It may help to ease the weight of her mourning.
How may I help you? As you have helped Atma and all of us, so shall I help you.
Hmm.
Welcome to the Desert Rain. We ran into one of those old tomb guardians when I ran with my bandits. I know they aren't easy foes to face, so you sure have my respect. Have you told Atma yet?
Who goes there? You've killed Radament, eh? That's quite a nice piece of work. If you ever need a job as a mercenary, I'd be happy to sign you up.
Your presence honors me. Atma's been telling everyone what you've done for her.
Ahoy, mate. Good job, mate. At night out on my ship, I was often awakened by that fiend's awful moaning. I'll bet I rest easier now.
Ask and learn. From what you tell me, it would seem that Radament was bent on the task of reviving his own mummified corpse with the flesh of the living. This is very unusual indeed. It takes an incredible magic power to alter the singular purpose of an undead mind. Perhaps there is a power at work here, which is beyond my ken.
Good evening.
I'm overburdened.
Greetings.
Greetings.
Greetings. Thank you.
Can't carry anymore.
Hello.
You have quite a treasure there in that Horadric cube. According to Horadric lore, the cube can restore a Horadric staff. To do it, use the cube as you would a scroll. When the cube opens, place both pieces of the staff into it and use the cube's transmute power. You'll be pleased to know that the cube has other alchemical uses as well. 6 gems plus 1 sword transmute into a socketed longsword. You may also transmute 2 quivers of crossbow bolts into 1 quiver of arrows, while 2 quivers of arrows yield 1 quiver of bolts. I must leave it to you to discover other formulae. Yes?
Blessings to you.
Hello.
Good day.
Good day.
Yeah!
I am overburdened.
Put that to good use.
Evening. The Staff of Kings! You astound me, my friend. You have discovered the shaft portion of a Horadric staff. I trust you know how to use a Horadric cube to unite the shaft with its headpiece.
It is an honor to serve you.
Day. I've been researching this lengthy eclipse, and I believe it to be the work of claw vipers. Find their temple beneath the desert sands, and you may find the source of this curse. Approach and let's trade.
Hi there. Two men arrived late last night bearing a story about evil magic. They said they saw a gathering of giant snake creatures performing some arcane ritual. They sound like the serpent men of the desert.
Good day. I have heard of your many deeds of skill and bravery. I feel I can trust you with something I have been hesitant to speak of. Drognan and I have concluded that the Dark Wanderer who passed through here recently was Diablo himself. Drognan believes that Diablo is searching the desert for the secret tomb where the great Horadric mage, Talrasha, keeps Bale imprisoned. You must find Diablo and put an end to the terrible evil that has fallen upon our city. Drognan is wise, and is sure to have some helpful advice for you as to how Talrasha's tomb may be found. It may take you quite some time to find the tomb. May you be ready when you do. My astrologers failed to predict this eclipse. You should seek Drognan's advice.
Good day. The sun has grown disgusted with the terrible deeds it must shine upon each day. Damnation is upon us all. Be very careful, my friend. I think I've seen enough recently not to doubt that these tombs exist. And if they do, they are most certainly guarded by terrible creatures.
Good to see you. This permanent darkness is very unsettling. It would make navigation by stars easier for me, though. I'm sorry, I can't help you much here. Now, if the tombs were across the ocean, then I'd be the guy to talk to.
Hey there! This whole place is one big ale fog. Oh, I'd go with you to those tombs, but, I don't like all that living dead stuff.
Good evening. Drognan the wizard will have some idea as to what is happening. I've heard legends of the tomb of Tal Rasha. But I thought they were just old tales meant to scare young children.
This unnatural nightfall is no doubt caused by evil sorcery. Drognan might know what we are dealing with. Legend has it that Tal Rasha lies imprisoned within his tomb, forever struggling to keep the Lord of Destruction bound. His was a selfless act, although perhaps foolhardy.
Good evening. Claw vipers. This outer darkness mirrors the inner blackness of their souls. It is they who have eclipsed the sun, I'll wager. They are a venomous band. When Tal Rasha chose to embody the spirit of Baal, he knew his doom was to wrestle eternally against the will of the greater evil. Look around you and ask yourself, has the battle been won or lost?
Drognan may have some advice on this matter. I think I'll speak with him myself.
That to good use.
Ah. Not enough mana.
The viper amulet you bear is actually the headpiece of a Horadric staff. Yes, you have an uncanny knack for finding rare and valuable artifacts. Of course, you'll have to use a Horadric cube to combine the headpiece with the shaft. I've been speaking with Lord Jerhyn, and I sense that he's becoming more and more agitated by something. You should try to talk to him again. If he still won't take you into his confidence, seek to prove yourself a bit more. I gather that his respect for you is growing. Stay a while and listen.